is from the Kansas State High School Activities Association and St. Thomas Aquinas High School. Athletic training services are provided for the Saints by Dr. Kurt McCullough, class of 1997, and Performance Rehab KC. Our team trainer is CJ Hess. In just a few moments, ladies and gentlemen, we'll have our opening prayer and our national anthem. Thank you. Gentlemen, at this time, would you please stand for our opening prayer and our national anthem by Aquinas Jr. Matthew 14. In the name of the Father, and of the Son, and of the Holy Spirit, amen. God, our Father, you have created us to strive for the best. Grant to all athletes, coaches, officials, and fans strength to pursue excellence during this event. We pray for the safety of these athletes. Protect them from injury and harm. And finally, dear Father, we pray for your grace, that you would provide us with the endurance to pursue our heavenly prize, eternal life in your Son, Jesus Christ. Amen. In the name of the Father, and of the Son, and of the Holy Spirit. Amen. And now, ladies and gentlemen, our national anthem.
Oh, dawn's early light.
the car fit, but she's not here yet. Oh, she just got here.
And 5'10 senior, number 44, Levy Zoll. The Stags head coach, Mike Allen.
They're just killing these threes.
They know how to shoot.
They do know how to shoot. I don't think.
Golly.
I don't think it's
gonna be a good game.
Oh, come on.
Dude, hey, whoever's keeping score.
Another
12. I thought it was 2.
Another turnover.
My goodness. Petzl must be mad.
I don't think Aquinas has ever had this low of this big of a lead against them at home in a while. But then again, I feel like there's been a lot of threes.
Oh,
ooh,
good
defense by Layla.
Maya's looking. Oh, sees Kelsey. Oh, yeah.
Kelsey wanted Kelsey's that basket.
Ready. We know we're having video difficulty. We're working on it.
Okay. There is video difficulty right now, but they are working on it and going to get it back up as soon as possible.
We got 44 out for number 1, Finley LeMay. She is a freshman. Hmm. Hopefully this is up to date.
Number 1 is in.
Looks up to date. Looks like she's 5'10".
Yeah. Yeah, she's against Tatum.
Yeah, against Tatum, yeah.
That's probably, right. That's definitely 5'10".
Yeah. All right, let's go freshman.
Saints ball. Jemiah's getting ready to pass it in.
Got a little zone defense right here.
No one has subbed out. So.
Started. I'm trying to see what Huck's saying here. I think he's talking about our defense.
Oh, he is. I think he's getting on them. Definitely about defense.
Maya's talking about giving some supportive.
Video is back on.
Alright.
Here we go. I want to be this. Like. Oh, that looks heavenly.
Anyways.
Jemiah's taking the ball down the court.
All right, we got 20 on Jemiah again. Man. Oh, man.
Alex trying not to get a foul. Let's see how this freshman plays. Doing good.
Man, Miege came out with some fire on her feet.
Yeah, there.
Man.
Okay, so the call is everyone's trying to get a travel call, which they're trying to figure out, did the travel come first or the foul?
I think they're trying to get 3 seconds.
I thought she traveled. She took, like, at least 3 steps.
I don't know, that was before
she, like, let go of the ball.
That could have been 3 different things, honestly.
Ah. Layla's taking the ball down. Trying to... Ooh, I thought she was going to drive.
Yeah, nothing open. Oh, yeah, good
Kelsey.
Pass.
There you go.
Yeah.
And one for Kelsey Shank.
There you go.
Looking for that foul. She got it. Hudson Welsh is now in.
She's playing kind of angry.
Hudson Welsh, number 3, a sophomore, came in for Jemiah McPherson.
Did you see that?
What?
Angry.
Yeah, she's playing with. Tatum Grimes. Subbed out by number 24. A freshman. She's been playing. I just can't remember her name.
I think her last name is Kalovich. I'm not sure.
It definitely is. I can't remember her first name, though. Kalovich is definitely right.
But she's really good. Oh, yep.
Travel. There we go.
All right. Now they're starting to go our way. Layla on point. Alright.
Oh, number 23 looking for a steal.
Oh, that's okay.
That's all good. Oh. That's just.
Tatum beats
that's weave head. Right there. That's a. You know what I'm talking about? Weave. Like the
weave. Yeah.
Ah.
It's a classic 20. Zone offense.
6-6, 6-18.
Classic press, I mean.
I'm hearing Miege's chant right now. I just don't know if
I'm not liking it.
I don't like the rock with the red. I like
it's gold, actually.
Tatum and Jemiah back in. 24 out. Layla's out.
There we go.
3 seniors and 2 sophomores on the court right now.
Here we go.
I don't think no.
I'm feeling good about this 5.
I am feeling good. They've all played at this varsity level for at least a year. Tatum took a break, did not play junior year.
Oh, man.
I asked Tatum about that, and I don't know if this is – pretty sure it's true. It was more of, like, her volleyball recruitment and just to make sure that no injuries were sustained during that. So a lot of, I think, athletes do that.
Yeah. It's a pretty common thing, I would say. It's just people were a little bit confused.
Wow.
They keep getting – man. Our turnovers are
insane.
Man,
wow, 23 is hustling.
They have so many steals. Oh, all right. Okay, that's about it. The steals are crazy.
Oh, they're huddling
some
up.
Good defense.
They're huddling
man.
Up. Some crazy defense.
They must be practicing that.
They definitely watched.
Cause
they're
not running many plays.
They definitely watched film on us because, like, they know.
Oh, definitely.
They had to, like, they
got
definitely.
Kelsey on lock.
They definitely studied that hard.
They see Kelsey down low, and they've just got her on lock.
They know that pass that they like to do, and they just have that, like, locked down.
Yeah.
That was ball.
All right.
I thought that was ball. I thought that was, like, jump ball or something, but.
We got a minute left in the first period, first quarter. They keep nailing down these threes too.
Yeah, that's there we go. They're being on these travel calls.
Yeah, these refs are picky tonight.
No, but they've definitely been nailing their threes. I don't think.
Yeah.
I think they've shot 2 threes that they've missed, and the other 8. That doesn't add up for math wise, but.
I don't know how many they shot.
I don't know, but they're shooting pretty good from the 3-point line.
Yeah, they're all up on Kelsey, man.
They know that. I feel like Tatum's a big passer at the post. Like, you get it there, she pops it out to you, and then. But Kelsey's definitely their strongest shooter down at the post.
Oh, yeah. She attacks hard.
She goes up, not even care if there's arms or not. Yeah, just running the clock. Did we say 20? Did we know 20's year or not?
No.
No.
But the other one's a junior. The other relative.
The other McCallop.
Yeah, I'm not sure.
Okay, to end our first quarter, it's 6 for the Saints and 18 for Miege.
I'll ask her during halftime.
Smart. Okay, we can do like a halftime interview.
Yeah, we'll fill you guys in if they're twins or not. Mystery twins. Are they twins or are they sisters or are they cousins? Who knows?
No one knows.
Who knows? But we'll figure it out. Don't worry.
No, we'll go into the locker room and we'll figure this out. Ah, Chef W is making her way up here.
Yes.
Mrs. Waldron's the food teacher at Aquinas.
My goodness, we made Eggs Benedict the other day.
I heard it was really good.
Oh my gosh, so good.
I heard it was really good.
So good. Best thing I've made in food.
How'd you make that?
So it's poached egg with a hollandaise sauce. The hollandaise sauce, I didn't notice, but it's egg yolks and butter. That's basically it.
Are you serious?
It is so good.
Wait, amazing. So a poached egg... Okay, so wait, that's just when... Okay, so you just, like, crack it?
You basically just crack it in the water.
Oh, the water.
Into boiling water.
Yes, the water.
Yeah, I'm really good at making poached eggs.
What's up?
Hi, Chef W. We're just talking about your foods class right now, actually. You want to say hi?
Who's we?
We're talking about our... Yeah, no. Okay.
She does not want to say hi, but that's okay.
I made pancakes today.
You made pancakes?
Yup.
Oh, man.
It took me and my other chefs a long time to get the temperature right for the stove.
Oh. A
lot of trial and error.
Oh, because you're in Foods 1.
I am in Foods 1.
Gotcha.
We were just talking about
this. Just talking about hollandaise
sauce. She was like,
sauce.
We didn't know that hollandaise...
Oh, my gosh. Chef W got super mad at one group because the hollandaise sauce made it lumpy.
Oh, that's
yeah.
Not, that's
yucky. It didn't follow directions. Yeah. They added the butter... too much at a time, and it got lumpy. Anyways, back to the game. Quarter two. Let's go. We're going to France next.
Going to France. Come to Aquinas so you can have
go
Chef W. Oh, go to France.
Anyways, they are going to Rome for spring break.
They're not, actually.
They're not?
No, they canceled this year.
Why?
I don't know. Oh my gosh. No, I know. They canceled it this year.
Why?
I don't know.
Just randomly?
Emmy Kopp was supposed to go to Rome.
Oh, is that why she's going to Florida?
Yeah, that's why.
I gotcha.
Her, the trip got canceled.
That's really disappointing.
Normally, they have a Rome trip every year.
Yeah.
Hildur's definitely knows something about it.
Yeah, definitely. Or Blaze.
Blaze. Come on, Jemiah.
Ooh.
Kelsey. Foul.
Yup.
There we go.
Oh. Okay.
On, yeah.
They're... I thought they did travel. I was like, that is not travel.
It's not travel. She
thought I saw that motion. I was like, no way.
I'm looking at John Burgess over there in the stands.
If you didn't know, John Burgess is Olivia Burgess's dad.
Dad, yes, correct.
BT Dubs. Yep, Kelsey. There we go.
Go,
Kelsey. She's 100% for her free throws tonight. Let's go.
Okay, I'm going.
All right, Chef W is going.
Bye, Chef W. Oh, wow.
Yup.
Yup. Hetzel is heavy on free throws.
Oh, yeah. Oh, Chef W is back.
Chef W is back.
No. Yeah, it's
There's
packed
no
tonight.
Room at the end.
Oh, sorry. You're welcome here.
Just like Mary from the Bible.
I don't get it.
There's no room in the inn.
I
love God. Oh, gotcha.
Took you a second. Even I knew that one.
I know. Thank you.
No, here we go.
Man. Oh my gosh.
Shout out Andrea Bassetti, who turned 18, legal adult today.
It is Andrea Bassetti's birthday today.
When's William Maher's?
I don't know.
Oh, it was
why?
A while ago, because she told me that they're doing a combined birthday party, and I was like...
Oh, that's right.
I was like, when was his birthday that you could do a
I guess I didn't get invited. Oh, man, Jemiah. That was a good shot, though.
It was like, it was just a little... I feel like I had too much spin on it. Oh, wow.
Yeah. She's good at those, though.
She is good at those, I think. But then again, Miege just, like, knows their stuff.
Yeah. Man. Their game IQ is so high.
I wonder how long they've had this coach.
I don't know. I feel like I've seen him before. I think he's been here a while.
I feel like he's been with Miege for a long time,
I don't know
too.
If it's Hetzel. I don't know if it's as long as Hetzel, but...
Go, Alex. Drive, 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 drive.
Fast
drive.
Break here.
See, look, and they...
Look for help. There we go.
Layla helping them out.
Oh, yeah.
Come on, Jemiah.
Oh, that's okay.
It's okay.
Yep, we got the offensive
there
rebound.
There we go, Alex. Offensive rebounds are...
Those are tough.
They're tough, but I feel like they're not mentioned enough.
They're what?
Like, defensive rebounds are like, get those. Like, those are like the ones that you... But offensive rebounds, like...
Because you don't really get them as often. Like, it's kind of like a given that once you shoot it, it's basically the other person's ball.
Yeah, but if you get that offensive rebound, you can keep the momentum on your side going.
Yeah, it's kind of tough to get those, though.
Yeah. I did not get a lot of those during my basketball tournament on Sunday.
We didn't get defensive or offensive.
We didn't get rebounds, period.
Yeah. Yeah.
Kelsey told us to spread the floor, and Ashlyn did not know what that meant. Neither did I, so we were a little confused.
I did not hear that.
It was during our pregame pep talk. She was like, spread the floor.
Oh, man, I wasn't there.
And Ashlyn was like, I don't know what that means.
Oh, man, that was a good shot.
That
good
was
defense
good
by Kelsey. All right, here we go. Come on.
Come on, Saints. Let's get the 20. Kelsey's looking for a shot. Got a drive instead. Shoots to Alex.
Oh, yeah.
Alex shoots it.
Yep. Wide open.
Alex Krauss, maybe? I think it's Krauss.
I'm not sure.
She's just like a walking. Like,
she is.
She's a shooter.
She's having a great game.
She is having a good game. Ah. She's just... She was a shooter freshman year, mainly like known for her threes, but this year she's been a lot more versatile.
Mm-hmm.
Like, she can really shoot.
Does she play club, do you know?
She must. She has to. There's no way her skills would be this good, like, on and off if she didn't play
she
club.
She must.
I think Hudson Welsh plays some club sport.
I don't know.
Because Tatum and Kelsey are club volleyball. Layla's club basketball. I assume Jemiah.
Does Hudson play soccer?
No. She plays a different spring.
Lacrosse?
20 was like on her.
Yeah, come on. Yeah, there we go.
20's smiling about that when 20 was like actively like hitting.
Yeah. Come on.
20, that's a valid foul. Please refrain. Oh, here comes the dance team.
They know.
I miss the dance clinic when they had all the little kids.
Oh, yeah.
I miss them. It's a good time. Kalovich in. I don't know for who, but Layla shoot in. It's close. That was a long shot. She's out.
There we go.
She was out. There we go. These refs have been pretty good calls all night. I feel like
here and there. Rough start.
I would agree the rough start, but I think the travel calls and the foul calls.
Yeah, now it's pretty even, but.
There we go, Layla. I feel like, gotta get Layla open more. I feel like there's not a lot of film on her. They just know that she's a good player.
Yeah. Oh man, right back at it. Hit him with the same thing.
Here we go. I'm always worried. I used to travel just because I would pick up my feet.
What?
I wouldn't move, but I would just stand and I would like twist
one
foot
man.
And then twist the other.
Why?
Because I was young and dumb. Like, that's just how. That's when
so you got a travel call by standing still?
No, not like standing still. I would move one foot and forget which one I moved, and then move the
like
other
one. Like a pivot?
Yeah.
Okay, I got it.
And I would just do, like, right as I did it, I remember, like, oh, that was the wrong foot.
I gotcha. What is that called?
I don't know what they just called. She shoots.
Shoot, man.
She scores.
Jeez, and she's a freshman.
She's tall for a freshman. I wish we could get Alex more open. Up on top, at least.
Man, when Layla drives to the middle, anyone drives to the middle, they all go in the middle. She needs to, like, pass it out, and then we'd be wide open for a three.
Number three just pushed Kelsey, and that was the funniest thing I've ever seen.
Oh, my gosh, I didn't see that.
No, it was, like, active. And then,
dang. Nothing's going wrong there.
Chef W, Kelsey. Do you know what's going on?
No.
That's
okay.
Okay,
Kelsey. Man.
17:30. This is a wild.
So, if halftime's like the senior night stuff.
Not now. It's between the games, not at halftime.
Oh, okay, good.
So
I was going to say, they need a little halftime talk.
No, it's going to be the senior night for girls and boys basketball will be after the girls game, but before the boys game.
Yeah.
Let's go, Layla. I can see Alex and Layla being a killer duo.
Oh, yeah.
And Hudson, too. Like, that whole group of three is about to be crazy for Aquinas basketball.
Yeah. As seniors, man.
Layla's a year younger.
Oh, that's right.
But, like, even then, like, I can see that
yeah.
could be really good. Look at her just driving.
She just drove through two people. Yup.
Let's go, Layla.
My goodness.
She drove straight
She's
through two people.
She's going crazy.
She
right
did, like,
now.
A layup move in the middle of the court. Like,
yeah, she did a little floater.
Oh, okay. It's been a lot of foul calls. Okay, I'm liking this score a little bit better.
All right, we're in bonus now.
If you don't remember the rule, it's that any fouls, once your team gets 5 fouls total, if you foul the other team any more, they automatically get the shoot. So even if it's not a shooting foul, they can shoot.
Yeah.
After, is it once when you hit 5 or after 5?
When you hit 5.
You hit 5? The fifth. Thank you, Chef W.
Layla just snagged that rebound.
Hudson.
And she wasn't even down on the block. Yup.
There we go. When did Kelsey get out? I just
they took her out before the foul. You're in bonus.
We took that a while to figure out that rule.
It's called bonus. If you didn't know.
Molly's explaining to me the rule. John Burgess is ready for halftime performance.
Molly, are you ready for tomorrow?
Yes.
Are you excited for tomorrow? What are you doing tomorrow?
Oh. Andrea, come on.
Mine? Okay. Oh, so it's not me. It's not my group. Man. Okay, I'm ready. All right, we got 20 with the ball.
18 seconds left in the half. 10-point lead by Miege.
Here we go, they're running out the clock.
Oh, my Lord.
Man. That's okay.
That's okay. Oh, sorry to everyone listening.
All right, Kelsey going back in for the next 5 seconds, 6 seconds. Oh, and Jemiah.
Here we go, here we go.
Let's see what they can do.
Hopefully it's...
Oh, they're pressing.
Just shoot it, Layla, just see what happens.
Oh, man.
Ah.
Running back to the half.
All right, end of the first half, 34 Miege. Saints
$10 and supports the dance program. Captains are awarded.
flipping around. This would be actually really good ASMR microphones. Honestly, this is a really good ASMR microphone. If you ever come near Molly McCarthy, she always says, "I'm just kidding around." See, yeah. I do really say I'm kidding around. I usually am kidding around, but most of the time when I say kidding around, I am not kidding around. Oh, wide open. Okay. She got lucky.
Don't foul. There was one time where Molly was not kidding around in October, and I was not.
Oh, my goodness. I know exactly what you're talking about. I was really not kidding around.
I was a little bit mean to Molly, and it did not result well.
No.
But we're here to tell the tale together, united.
I don't want to talk about the tale. It came up at WPI, too. In the car. The Uber. Oh, yeah.
Yes,
Kelsey,
let's go, Kelsey.
Bet.
Great. Great ball movement by Alex. Just got to pass it around. No kin around. Just pass it around.
If we just pass it around, then we'll get them mixed up. They're used to us driving.
On God.
You just got to pass it around.
They normally have a really good passing game. Like, it's just going all over the place. It's like one of those cup games that, you know. Oh, go Chef W.
What cup game?
You know when, like, you watch the video and they, like, put something under your cup and then, like, it moves?
Oh,
you
can't tell. Gotcha.
That's what sometimes I feel like they're passing game.
Oh, Jemiah.
Don't foul,
okay, good
Jemiah. I want to know if they, like, trash talk each other, like, during the game.
Definitely not. Oh, man, their shots are off.
Hey, they're stressing. You got to get them uncomfortable.
We finally broke under 10.
Come on,
point differential.
Let's go!
Has she missed? I don't think she's missed.
She hasn't. I think Alex Krause is shooting 100% right now.
That is crazy.
Is that how that
Come
works?
Come on.
Is that how?
Yeah.
Yeah. Or when is it? Oh, that's something else. I'm thinking of a different sport, how they do that. But Alex, honestly, she's really done a lot for this game. She's been moving the ball around, making her shots. Fairly impressed. They have an electric guitar in the band. Molly plays guitar, if you didn't know
I
that.
I do. Yep. I have played electric guitar, acoustic guitar. That's it. Oh, ukulele. That's not a guitar.
You've played the drums, though. What? Yep. Ukulele's not a good. Is it just its own thing?
Yeah, I think so.
That's kind of cool. I didn't know that.
I think they're cousins. Ukulele and guitar. Oh, I forgot to ask if they're twins. Man, that's okay.
What if we just yell it at the coach? It's like, hey, do you got twins on your roster or relatives?
Or like one of the parents. Honestly.
What if we...
Whatever.
We could look it up.
Could we?
I feel like on their Instagram, if they were twins, they would post with each other. Ask Chef...
If you can hear Chef W yelling, comment down below.
Ask Chef W if she thinks 20 and 23 are twins or just relatives.
Chef W, do you think... Chef W, do you think number 20 and 23 are twins? It says that they have the same last name on the roster, 20 and 23.
So...
They could just be cousins or sisters, though, but
if you didn't
we're
thinking
they're twins.
Alex just got a really hard travel call that a lot of parents
are
upset
with. You think they're
twins?
Yeah. I don't know. They might be sisters.
I'm thinking sisters.
Yeah, maybe cousins.
Go,
they
Alex.
Don't look very much alike.
What? Come on, Jemiah.
We can't see.
These refs have been on these travel calls.
The refs have been on us.
They have been...
They've been on the other team, too.
They've, like,
all around.
They've
man.
Been very nitpicky. If it's not a clean stop and a clean start, then they're going to assume it's a travel. Like, they have been super nitpicky on that.
Yeah.
They just called, you're talking to Chef W, but they called one on Alex right over there. That made everyone very upset.
Oh, man.
Gosh. Defense!
Yes, Chef W.
Yep, defense. Oh, man.
29-35, 36.
Wasn't even a 5 on the board. Don't know where I got that. Tatum's looking to pass. Hey, yeah, maybe they're trying to run the play that we ran.
Oh, good
yes.
move, Kelsey.
Great job, Kelsey.
Good move. All right, we're a 5-point difference. Here we
really
go.
Really great spin move by Kelsey Shank.
This is the shortest
Shank.
We've been the whole game.
This
Let's
is.
Let's go.
We have
or the closest. Whatever.
I think, honestly, I think we keep feeding the ball to Alex. And, you know, keep passing the ball, keeping them on their toes.
Oh, there she is again.
We just
Number
gotta
one.
We just got to be faster than them.
Yep. Hey, I don't read. Oh. Okay, yeah. Oh, that's good. Forgot we switched sides. Thank you for that.
Yeah, see?
Thanks for reminding
my
me.
My reminder is proven well. People don't take it
seriously.
They think I'm just talking.
They
but
think I'm just kidding around.
They think I'm just kidding around. No, I'm not. I'm helping my friends.
Ayudar.
Ayudar.
Ayudando.
Ayudar is to help in Spanish. It's a verb.
My peer tutor class is Spanish. Thank goodness.
Molly's a
so I'm
crazy at Spanish.
I
oh, they ran stack.
Spanish. Oh, they did run stack.
Don't know what
Alex open. Oh.
I just really hope.
The classic stack.
Wow, their defense is like on.
Oh, man, good grab, Jemiah.
Great
yes.
grab, Jemiah.
Come on, let's go, Jemiah.
Oh, look at her speeding down the court. That was, honestly, you just got to be the tougher, you have a girl. Travel?
Yup. Let's go, Kelsey.
Took a charge foul instead. We'll take it.
Let's go, Kelsey. Kelsey was not expecting that.
No, I don't think she was. I don't feel like you never, like, you always want a charge, but sometimes you just don't get it, and then you just gotta move on.
All right, Dr. We're running Ford, bullseye.
Dr. Ford is here.
Where? Oh, I see him.
He was the president for Aquinas two presidents ago, so not the
yeah.
one. Not, who was the one?
It was our one 3 years ago.
Not Falcon. Fallon.
I don't.
Not Falcon.
I don't know.
Dr. Fallon is who we had our freshman year. And then Dr. Ford was the one that was there for like 20 years before we got here to Aquinas.
Oh, we didn't even have him?
We never had him.
Oh.
But we had Dr. Fallon for like a year.
Gotcha.
And then President Brian Shank took over.
Wasn't he principal? Wasn't there someone else that was president?
No. Well, Brian Shank was the interim.
He's been it for 3 years now?
Yeah. Oh. Or 2.5, maybe. I think 2.5, because he was the interim one for a little bit.
Oh.
I don't know if that's accurate, but...
What's the difference between president and principal? What's president mean?
Principal is more on, like, the students, I feel like. Like, you focus on, like, the students and, like, their activities.
Okay.
And I feel like the president focuses on the school's, like, reputation and the school's activities towards, like, other people.
Okay, gotcha.
Like, Craig Moss and DiCarlo and all them, they're focused on, like, academic principals, so students' academics or disciplinary. Or Greason is, like, all this.
Gotcha. Yup. Great defense, Alex.
Great defense. But Mr. Shank focuses on, like extravaganza, making sure, like, kind of how the school's activity should go.
Yeah.
Not as much like us.
I gotcha. Man, it's getting close. 4 points now.
This is insane.
This is crazy. Man, Hetzel must have given a great pep talk.
Don't call a foul. That's fine.
Oh! All right.
What?
Man.
I feel like she just fell. That's my personal.
She just fell.
That's my opinion.
I agree.
Think.
It's because they called the charge call, so we're like, oh. Well, like, if they're calling charge, then we're falling.
Then, like, we're going to fall.
That's definitely what they thought.
It sounded like she fell hard, but I think that's just because she just didn't catch herself. Like, if you're going to fall, like, you got to kind of sell that. 35 has, Kelsey has 3 fouls. That's not amazing, but
three? No, that's like our whole team.
No, it just showed. Kelsey has three.
How?
I don't know.
The quarter just started.
Well, three total.
But it's only been one quarter. What?
It's been three quarters.
But they start over.
It just showed 35-3 on the board.
Huh. Maybe they did last quarter. So that doesn't make sense.
I didn't know that was a thing. I thought the team foul start over, but individual. I don't really know what I'm saying. I just know.
Oh, do the individuals not?
What do you mean? There we go.
Maybe the individuals don't. Huh.
It just said 35-3. I think it resets each quarter, but
for the team,
for the overall team. Or not each quarter, each half.
How did I never realize that? That's crazy.
But Kelsey still has three fouls for the entire game, so she can still foul out.
I feel like they, I don't know.
They be changing the rules.
Let me look it up.
We're about to look it up for everyone listening.
I feel like I'm going to feel dumb either way.
Don't feel dumb either way. It's bad. Like, it's confusing. Hudson Welsh. See, 44 has two fouls. What are they? This is an interesting. Kelsey's back in. Okay, they're doing. Come on, Layla, let's shoot it.
Okay.
Don't. So. Come on, Tatum. Oh, wow. So what we're finding out right now, trying to figure out what it is.
Okay.
I'm pretty sure it's the team fouls reset after the half for the bonus rule, but the individual fouls, like per player, you can don't reset. I feel like that makes sense because, like, if you're getting a total of 8 fouls a game, 4 in each half, that's kind of crazy.
Huh.
Well, we're going to watch to see who fouls next, and then I'm going to look at that board.
Wow. It says they don't.
Oh. 22, watch your elbows, sweetie. Elbowing is, like, so dangerous. If you see a senior at Aquinas, John Tyson, has a very bad black eye from getting elbowed.
Who elbowed him?
Maverick Farrar.
Man.
Did you see? It's like...
No, I haven't.
Go, Layla.
Something fell. Her nail fell, I think.
Is she wearing nails?
I don't know. Maybe...
Oh, I think it's bleeding.
I think her nail did fall.
I feel like...
Something.
30 seconds left in this third quarter.
Yeah.
Tatum is telling where the ball needs to go. Tatum said ball is going this way. Good, Tatum.
Alex is having a great game.
I love the parents that get, like, into it, but in, like, a good way. Like, there's some of the Southwest parents were getting into it in a bad way. Like, they were, like, commenting on our team.
Oh.
Like, they would yell, be like, I think they yell something either against, like, our team's, like, height or something. I don't know. They're just, like,
what?
I don't know.
Have you seen Tatum?
I think it was a boys' game. That's what's weird.
Oh, I gotcha.
Like, I think it was 7 seconds left. Oh. Oh. As well.
Little confusion here.
Kelsey out for the last.
I think her name's Sophie.
Sophie Kalvich?
I think that's what they said. All right, we got a little press going on. I'm loving it. Yup.
There we go.
Way to play that.
Let's go, Alex.
Way to play
Alex
that.
Alex is killing this game.
She is murdering it. Holy.
She is going to be a weapon for... She's going to be a weapon for... Holes.
Whoa, that is a horrible call.
What?
These calls are crazy.
That call, if you would have... That last call, I just don't know if that was the right one to make. I feel like if you look at the team on both sides. Yeah. You know, like if you would have saw how, like, I feel like it's kind of a difference.
All right. 8 minutes left in this game.
Here we go. Let's finish it out here. Behind by three. Oh my goodness. This is such a good game.
This has been we knew this was gonna be a good game.
This has been so exciting.
This has been a very high intense, high energy game from both sides of the court. Defense, offense, Miege, Aquinas.
Here we go.
44, the senior. Going, looking for...
All right, we got Alex on number 20. Oh. They run a little bit of a zone, actually.
Hey, I do not like zone. Oh, she...
Oh, yeah. Way to get the ball.
Come on, Layla.
To Jemiah.
There we go.
What a shot. That was a great team.
It's a 1-point game.
Great ball movement. That's going on, Kansas athletes.
Oh.
She's really playing the... She's really playing it up.
No, like...
I'm loving it, though.
Who are you talking about?
Alex.
Alex.
He's really playing it up.
10.
I'm loving it. I mean, if they're going to call the charge calls.
Number 10, 4 fouls.
Okay, gotcha. Oh, she's almost fouled out. Oh.
Yeah, that's not good.
I mean, if they're calling the charge calls, take it.
If they're going to call it, they have to call it whenever they see it. You know what I mean? Like, if they don't call charges at all throughout the game, like, that sucks, but you can't.
It's all or nothing.
Yeah, it's all or nothing. But... all of these refs, I feel like, have been very, like, on the game.
Yeah.
And I feel like they're known for that throughout the league. Like, they know that these refs will call whatever they see.
Yeah. I'm loving it. Keeps the game going.
It does.
And again, you got to play some really good defense to...
I feel like Miege has, like, recently been, I don't know how long they've been, like, really good, but...
Oh, they've always been good.
Have they always been?
Yeah.
Because I knew this year they've been really...
In, like, everything.
This year they've been really good.
Yeah.
This year, especially in the basketball scene, they've really taken a strong foot forward.
They've always been good at football.
But really?
it's always like the Catholic schools. We always have the big rivalry between
them
anyways.
Oh, yeah, the Catholic school. There's like a...
Like the Catholic. The trifecta. I guess Rockhurst is in there too, but... It's the trifecta.
I would say the rivalry is strong between St. James, Miege. Shoot it, Tatum.
Yep.
There we go, Jemiah.
Stay aggressive.
Oh, yeah. Awesome. Yes! Let's go.
Yes, me and Molly are really excited.
Oh, man, that was awesome. That ball movement was crazy. We are
Jemiah
on.
Taking that ball back, Kelsey taking the initiative to get it to Tatum, and Tatum just going up strong.
Man. We're playing great this half. Oh, man.
They are.
This halftime talk must have been amazing.
Yep. That halftime talk must have been.
Oh, man. We're ahead. Ahead by one. Let's go.
I'm like
first lead. First lead we've had all game in the fourth quarter with 6 minutes left. Crazy.
I don't think not many teams could say they could do that.
No. This is an awesome game.
Like, if you don't. It's okay.
It's all right. See, what are we running? We're in a line.
Oh, I'm here for myself.
I wonder what that's called. Let's
here
go.
We go. Here we go. Here we go.
Man, tied up.
Tied game with 5 minutes left. This is
hype. I'm loving this. Wow.
This is a close game.
This is awesome.
This is awesome. I'm nervous.
Pressure is a privilege. Let's go.
Amen.
Oh, man. Great
that's
shot.
That's a great shout from you, Molly.
Yeah, it's not for me.
Who's it from?
Back in my softball days, our coaches would say that all the time.
Pressure is a privilege?
Yeah, I never understood it.
I think I kind of understand it.
I do, too. I understand it, but I never related it. Like, I was like, oh, man, this is, like, terrible. Like, I hate this feeling.
Yeah.
Never thought of it as a privilege.
I get that. Maybe it's more of, like, if you get to play on that stage or play on that scene, like, be happier there.
Yeah.
With the pressure.
Oh, for sure.
Oh, the freshman. I don't know. I forgot her name. Number one is checking in for number 44 for Miege.
Here we go.
She has really pretty red hair.
Yeah, like she reminds me of the princess from Brave.
Yeah, she does.
In a good way.
Like, it's, like, very pretty.
Yeah.
So, shout out number one from Miege. You got... You ever... Your hair's pretty.
Come on, let's go.
Here we go, here we go.
This is hype.
This is hype. I'm, like... 1 point lead by Miege. This is insane.
Kelsey Shank said this would be a good game. Oh, wide open. Great shot.
It was a great shot. They got her open quick.
We got Alex going in. Alright, here we go.
Tatum's cutting in. My basketball coach used to tell us that, like, if you weren't, come on, Tatum, go. That if you weren't, if you're standing still and you're not with the ball,
then you're not doing the right thing. That's what my basketball coach used to tell me.
Yep. Basketball, you're always moving.
They are.
And if you're not, then that's not great.
Ugh. I hate how, like, it's like if they just get it past you, it sucks, because then, like, they just can shoot it. Like, on the post, because, like, more than likely, if you try anything, then you're going to get a foul. Oh.
Yeah.
Timeout for Aquinas.
Timeout Saints.
Timeout Saints. Matthew's getting into it.
What a good song. Oh, John brought his own trumpet to join in.
Nope, yeah. He's says
loving it up.
He has like a decent, like he has an increase of band members this year, but just the trumpet, he's like, I just gotta help him out.
It's fair. I don't recognize anybody.
No, it's a big freshman class.
Oh, okay.
And especially since he was letting the like guitar players play, they were like all about that. I'm pretty sure they asked him, like, hey, can we play like guitar, electric guitar? And my dad was like,
oh, is that Colin Allen up there?
Yeah, Colin Allen's up there and Brendan Follis. Those are the only two
seniors. Where's Brendan? I don't see Brendan.
Brendan Follis, I think he's on drums right now.
Oh. That does not look like Brendan.
Ugh.
Maybe he got a haircut. Oh, shoot.
And one.
Dang. Oh, I guess it might be Brendan. Shout out Brendan Follis.
Brendan Follis and Colin Allen are the band seniors.
Oh, man.
Shout them out.
We're getting a little bit behind again. Oh, no. It's okay.
So now you're just going to serve
the class. This is, we'll pull it together. This is just a crazy.
All right,
Hetzel would not let those slide. Like, he's, again, like no. We've said all throughout this season, he's on them about free throws.
Oh, yeah. Oh,
Jemiah's got it.
Jemiah's got it.
What is she yelling about? Oh, there she goes. Looking, there yep. We go, Jemiah.
She finds a way.
Jemiah does find a way.
There's always a way. Jemiah finds it.
Go, go. Yeah, that's Brendan Follis playing the drums.
He must have gotten a haircut. He's shredding right now.
Oh, Bella Sanchez with the pictures.
Oh, yeah. Shout out.
She has a big camera.
Yep. In your book.
Also proud of Bales. Never mind. Hey, McCarthy Auto Group, is that you?
It's not me.
What?
Fortunately.
Hi, BLs. They'll walk out. Sorry. For senior night, if you're planning on watching, I'm assuming they're going to be walking out from the doors near the flag. That's what they did for cheer and dance. And I just assume that to be right. So, because they walk out and then they stop in the middle and then they line up right there. That's what they did for cheer and dance. So,
solid.
I think they would do the same. I think they've always done it that way.
Oh, don't give it to her. Okay.
Let her.
Out of bounds.
One time I did one of those throws and I got it, but I landed on a chair. And
oh,
so I was like,
that's not good.
I like landed on it hard.
That must have hurt.
Yeah, but I got yelled at because I didn't get up fast enough to get back in the game.
Get up!
No, yeah, because they just sprinted down and I didn't notice that. So then I was not doing too hot.
we go. Oh, 3 seconds. That is not what we needed.
Here we go. Alex is pressing. 2 minutes left. 55-49. Miege.
Oh, man. Oh, no, that's five.
This is a...
Hey, better to be too aggressive than not at all.
Yes, I agree. Because if you're, like, you don't want to give them easy shots. I feel like, because if you're still being aggressive, it shows that you're still, like, pushing for that ball. You're still pushing to win. Yes, Tatum. See, look at that. Because you never know when you're not going to foul.
Right. You never know when you're going to not.
Oh, man. Oh, I wanted that to go in. I wanted that to go in so bad.
Oh, are they just... Yep. That's all right. That's expected.
Here we go. Here we go. Here we go. All
right.
I like that. Miege boys basketball is good too, right?
I think so. I'm not sure, but probably.
Oh man. Two missed. Oh. That's. What?
Wow.
I know, it's
crazy.
It is crazy. What are they clapping for? Wait, why is she shooting again? Did she just get fouled?
I think it was a violation.
Of the lane?
Yeah.
Oh my goodness. That is crazy.
Okay, that's crazy.
Hey, we get two threes, we're golden.
Yeah, you're fine.
Go, Don.
Come on, Tatum. Here we go.
Out. Back.
Yep.
Good. Good, 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 good.
Yep. Here we go. Here we go.
Alex, there we go.
All right, here we go. Come on.
Come on, Saints.
Yeah.
Go, Kelsey, go. There we go, Kelsey. There you go, Kelsey.
Great shot, Kelsey. Come on. Let's go.
Come on.
Hold him right here. Put the pressure on. Hudson drawing the foul.
Oh, my
Lord. Giving the foul, I mean. All right, that's okay. It's okay. Everything is fine.
Here we go. Jemiah's getting ready. Oh my. Molly. Jemiah's getting ready to time out by Miege.
Here we go.
Don't know why.
Come on. Let's go.
I am like.
We got two threes. Two threes to tie.
This has been quite a game.
Two threes to tie, baby. Let's go.
Bella Sanchez is letting Elena Vate use her camera. She is killing it. Bella Sanchez is still letting them take pictures.
Oh, don't trust them.
Elena's having way too much fun, I can tell. Oh, here she goes.
Shout out Elena.
Elena is a freshman. Well, she'll be a four-year varsity for volleyball, and she'll be a four-year varsity for softball.
Yeah, I keep thinking she's a freshman.
She's a sophomore. There we go. Another timeout for Aquinas.
Here we go.
No, yeah, she is a sophomore.
Plenty of time. We've got plenty of time.
No, they've done more with less.
Two baskets. Let's go.
More with less.
See.
Oh, if I could take a nap like that right now.
Oh my goodness.
That's a good nap, too.
Oh, yeah.
Face down on the bleachers is crazy.
That is crazy. Wow. Oh. It's so cool.
It's the funniest thing I've ever seen.
So cute.
Here we go. Alex is not in.
I think she fouled out.
Did she foul out?
I think so.
I thought she had four.
I think she fouled out.
That's heartbreaking.
My House by Flo Rida. Let's go. Florida. Sorry, I don't know why I said that.
I was like, Florida.
I think, like, I say that because Florida, you know, Florida.
Florida. Oh.
Oh, man. We're, like, triple teaming right now.
Yeah, we're trying to get this ball back. This has been quite the game. Are they wearing? No, they're not wearing. I thought they were wearing the Play for Lec shirts, boys team. They are not. But they did wear them for like three games.
Yeah, they did.
For a while.
Very kind. Even when they weren't playing Southwest, too.
No, yeah, they wore them for Blue Valley. Come on, Kels.
Oh, man. Let's go.
Let's pull this ball down. Shoot it, Layla. Come on.
Let's go. Dang, in for the three. Just what you needed.
Let's go.
Let's go.
Bang, baby.
Here we go.
It's
walking. Right now. That was clutch.
Layla has been able to play really well.
Man.
Layla definitely has that mindset.
Oh,
pressure,
yeah,
is a privilege.
Yeah. We're hungry for it. They're hungry for it right now. But same with Miege. They are too.
No, Miege, they want this win. Any game between St. James, Aquinas, and Miege has like an fueled rivalry just because of the Catholic, they're the most well-known Catholic schools in the Kansas.
Yeah, honestly, yeah. I mean, yeah, St. Teresa,
well, I feel like St. Teresa's and Rockers at a different, at a disadvantage because they're boys only or girls only.
Right.
So, like, when it comes to football, everyone's like, Rockers, like, beat them, but, like, in volleyball, I'd say in volleyball it's more of
Scion? No.
Are they co-ed? No.
No, they're all girls.
I would say Aquinas definitely has a target on their back in most sports.
Oh, yeah.
If not all of them.
Yeah. I'd say all of them.
Yeah, I would say all of them.
Can't think of one that's not.
I can't think of one where they're like, they don't want.
Maybe like lacrosse.
They're going to run this clock. They're going to run this clock.
Actually, that's...
Steal the ball.
Come on. go, yes! Yes! Go, go, go!
Let's go!
Yes! 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 Yes!
Oh my goodness! Oh my goodness! Oh my goodness! Let's
oh my
go!
God.
Let's go! We're out of our seats right now, folks.
We're standing.
Oh. Yes! Yes! Hold it! Hold it! Hold it! Hold it.
Let's go!
Let's go!
Let's go!
Let's go!
Let's go.
Dang.
Oh,
come on!
Oh my lord!
Let's go!
Me and Molly are standing!
Oh my goodness!
Me and Molly are standing!
Everyone in this gym is standing.
Everyone is standing. 6 seconds
let's
left
go.
In the fourth quarter.
Come on!
Thanks
let's
to
go!
This is
come
it.
Come on!
This is it.
I'm so excited!
Chef W is excited.
All right, here we go. We're running it.
Molly is
we
crouched
gotta,
over.
We gotta press defense right now. Let's go.
Five.
Yup.
Here we go, here we go.
Alright, man. Layla literally
Layla.
Game winning. Game winning.
That game winning defense? That's
oh man.
Oh my god.
This is crazy. This is the craziest thing I've seen
this
all
has
week,
been
folks. Wow. That's okay, that's okay. Oh. It's okay, Kelsey. Hey.
Hey,
D up.
It's 4 seconds. They
let's
have
go.
To, they have to shoot the ball in 4 seconds. It's not.
Let's go D up right here. They're going to
time
run
out
the
whole Miege.
Play.
Time out Miege.
All right.
I like my legs are shaking.
Oh, man.
Meanwhile, there is this adorable little kid in front of us who has been asleep the entire game.
Oh, my goodness.
Chef W.
Chef W.
I am. I'm shaking.
Oh my goodness. This is awesome. I'm loving this.
I think this is an insane.
The heart rate is going
the
up.
The atmosphere here right now is insane.
I know.
Dance team people are standing.
Yeah.
Majority of parents have sat down, but they were standing.
All right, let's go. Here we go.
It's been an insane.
D up. Let's go.
This has
come
been
on. Come on.
It's been an insane game.
D up right here.
The stakes are.
Let's go.
One stop. And it won. Aquinas won. And Aquinas won. Aquinas has won the game 58-57. They had a majority 10 points. They're at a disadvantage for most of the game. They were behind by 10 points for majority of the game. Halftime, they turned it around. Great game.
United States Military Academy at West Point, where she is committed to play volleyball. Next up, number 23 is a stay the course, make lots of memories, stay close to God. After graduating from Aquinas, Jemiah plans to serve in the United States Air Force. Jemiah! And last but not least, number 35, Kelsey!
Soccer is president yacht club. Next year, Cooper plans to play basketball and study accounting and finance. Number two, Cooper Watt. Thank you.
Welcome to Halo Sports, where we are looking at a great matchup here. The Saints going up against the Bishop Miege Stags. Right now they're doing the lineup for Bishop Miege. Senior night here at Aquinas, so recognizing our seniors, Cooper Welsh, Wyatt Lewis, and Joe Loafman. The girls game, the girls won in a very close game here at the end. 57-56, pretty sure that was the final score. Here's a little hype video. I am Matthew Fortino, and here is your starting lineup. Cooper Welsh, number two. He is 6'1", a lot taller than I am. And next up, Isaiah Freeman, 6'3", also taller than I am, fun fact. London Burton Jr., also, actually, yeah, no, he is taller than me. 6'1". Wyatt Lewis going out there. Starting lineup. He's also 6'1". And Joe Loafman, also 6'3". That's your starting lineup for the Saints. It's going to be a great game today. 8 minutes on the clock. Three of the finest refs that the Eastern Kansas League has to offer. Your executive producer today is Max Broomfield, running the camera and the stream, so we apologize ahead of time for any hiccups. It might freeze occasionally, but it's a quick fix and it will be back up, so don't freak out, not your TV, it's us. And here we go for the tip-off. Both number 11s on both teams going out there. A.J. Mulland for the Stags and Wyatt Lewis for the Saints. And it goes the way of the Stags. Tipped out of bounds by Wyatt Lewis. See what the Saints can do on defense. Wyatt Lewis with the coverage. And the Stags make a bucket for two. Zay bringing it down the court for the Saints. Passing it around. Cooper Welsh looking for a pass to London Burton. Back to Cooper. To Zay. To Wyatt Lewis, who looks for something. Gets it to Cooper. London tries to pass to Zay. Gets tipped. Stags ball. Pushing their way up the court. Saints back on defense. Stags pass it inside, and they make, I think it's a two, but I didn't really tell. It was a two. Saints with the ball. Joe Loafman on the inside. Almost gets it in. London Burton tries to get the rebound. Joe keeps fighting. On the ground. Stags ball. Crash in the lane. Passing it around the key. Saints defense. London tries to steal the ball. Zay. Tried for a three for the Stags. They don't get it. Cooper Welsh looking for a pass. Takes it by himself. Takes it back out to the 3-point line. Passes it around. Zay with the ball. Pass it to London. London looking for the big man on the inside, Joe. Cooper Welsh with the ball, thinking about it to Wyatt Lewis. Wyatt Lewis takes it on the inside, tries to go up for the ball, or for the basket, does not get it. Gets stolen. Cooper Welsh trying to break up the travel from the Stags. Number 12. Cooper Welsh taking the ball. Back up the court. Calling out his play. Looking for a pass. No one's open. Wyatt Lewis maybe. Switches sides of the court completely. Pushes to the inside. Pass it to Wyatt Lewis, who pops the three and nails it. Back on defense. Saints down 3-4. London. Zay trying to break it up. Travel. Saints call timeout. 5 minutes, 17 left. Got an amazing student section out here today. I think I might be able to name everyone. I lied, but I can name those three fine gentlemen in the front there. Charlie Ford, Max Curran, Maverick Farrar. Love the Saint spirit today. We got the band going. It's great. All the cheerleaders. Look at the band. That lovely stand custom built for the bleachers to house the drums. Fun fact, the drums actually used to just sit on the bleachers, and it was really sketchy. But now, they got a platform. Gotta love it. Zay passing it in to Cooper Welsh, who takes it up the court. Welsh pushing it into the for a layup. Can't get it. Joe Lovin with the rebound. Tries to put it back up. Just goes over the back. They're going to call this jump ball. And it goes the way of the Saints. Good rebound there. Will Good going in for Joe Loafman. Zay tries to put up a shot, does not get it, and it is tipped out of bounds by the Saints. Will Good, who is 6'9", I think he is the tallest man on the court right now. Zay, the defense. London tries to put up some pressure. Seems to have worked. Saints trying to get a stop. 4:31 left on the clock. Only three buckets made by both teams tonight. 3-4. Slow start here for both teams. Zay trying to put the pressure on. Cooper Welsh defending. Stags take it to the inside for the layup. 6-3. Welsh taking it down the court. Pass it to Lewis. Lewis thinks about the three. Takes it in. Pass it back out to Zay. Zay thinks about it, stops to Wyatt from afar. Oh, almost with the alley-oop there from London. And Will Good gets the easy layup. I don't really know if you can consider that an alley-oop, but that was going to be cool. Luckily, the other Saints come out with two. 5-6, down by one. 3:33 left on the clock. London with the pressure, and Stags make a little jumper. Welsh to Lewis. Lewis goes in, goes to the outside. London for the three, gets it. What an easy bucket. 8-8. Tied up. Stags. Passing it around. Zay. Guarding. Lewis. Good. Welsh. Stags trying to see if they can make a play. Saint's going to stop it. London with the defense. That's an air ball. Will Good. Pass it to Zay. Zay takes it up. Looking for a pass. Or takes it alone. Nope. Passes it out to London. London to Lewis. Lewis takes it inside. Thinks about it. Passes it out to Welsh. Welsh can't do it. Gives it to Will. Back out to Welsh for the three. Bucket. Amazing passing. Way to move the ball. See if they can keep this streak alive on defense. 11-8. London. Zay covering. Stags trying to set a screen. They don't. Wyatt Lewis with the rebound. Taking it down court to London Burton, who puts it up for the layup. Makes the bucket. 13-8. Excuse me. 1:34 on the clock in the first quarter. No fouls. Pretty clean game so far. Zay trying to knock the ball loose. Can't seem to do it. London putting the pressure on. Saints finding their man. Passing it around. The Stags. And they're going to call. I don't know what they just called. Maybe a push-off travel. Not sure. But that would be on the Stags. In comes Colin Smith for Zay Freeman. And Joey Goodnow comes in for Cooper Welsh. We have four juniors out on the court, one senior. That one senior being Wyatt Lewis, who currently has the ball. Going to take it inside, passes it to London, who puts up the three and makes it from the same spot. He's hot in that corner. London. Colin Smith putting the pressure back on. Burton looking for a way to stop this. Smith, now it's Lewis. Stags are just passing it around. 16 seconds left, clock is winding. They're gonna call a hold on Colin Smith. Eight to 16. Saints have an 8-point lead. 14 seconds left. Let's see if the Stags are going to do anything. I have a feeling the Saints might stop them. Put up a shot by the Stags. They don't get it. Joey Goodnow gets the rebound, but 0 seconds. Winds down our first quarter. 16-8. Solid lead for the Saints. Second quarter, probably going to look to expand their lead. But here is a little video.
I'm Joey. I'm a junior. I'm playing hot seat.
I'm Cooper, and I'm a senior, and I'll be joining them.
What's your favorite color?
Blue.
Blue.
What's your favorite food?
Meatloaf.
Steak.
Hot chocolate or coffee?
Hot chocolate.
You could be one of your coaches. Who would it be?
Nussbaum.
What's your favorite animal?
Dogs.
Dogs.
Who talks the most on your team?
Wyatt, say.
Who's the funniest on your team?
Me.
Loveman.
Who's the quietest on your team?
Joey G.
Colin Smith.
If you could change places with one of your teammates, who would it be?
Joe Loveman.
Wyatt.
Sing me your favorite song.
Oh.
A, B, C, D, E, F, G, H, I, J, K,
McDonald's or Taco Bell?
Taco Bell.
Canes or Popeyes?
Canes.
What do you get from Chick-fil-A?
Ooh, I get the 12-count nugget with a large fry and a large
Powerade. Oh. No, Powerade.
Ooh. Bye.
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 That was a little fun video that the boys did, getting to know them a little more. Trying to do that more. All right, starting our second quarter here. 8 more minutes left on the clock. 16-8. The Stags are going to get the ball. And same. Nope, I lied. Not the same. Will Good is out, and so is Wyatt Lewis. They are replaced by Cooper Welsh and Joe Loafman back in the game. Joey with the intense defense. They're going to call a foul on him. I think it's a little weak, but what do I know? I'm just the announcer, not the ref. Joey's a very good defender, I must say. Every single time I watch him out there, he's very on top of it. Stags with the inbounds play. See if the Saints can stop him. Try to pass it to the outside. Collin with the up and down. I think they're going to get him for the foul. He was indeed very up and down, maybe just a little too sideways. Stags make their first free throw. Shooting for the Stags is number 12, Liam Tesmer. Freshman. Playing on varsity. Good for him. Zay with the inbounds to Joey. Joey and Zay playing a game, a little catch in the backyard, passing it back and forth. Joe Loafman takes it across the half-court line. Wyatt Lewis is in for Collin Smith, by the way. He takes a little fader, just rolls off the rim. Stags get the rebound. They take it down the court, looking to push on the inside. Joe Loafman tries to defend it as best he can, but the Stags get the lucky roll. They're pressing in the back, and Zay passing it around, switch sides of the court multiple times. They get it to Wyatt Lewis across the thing. Wyatt thinks about the shot, gives it to Zay for the three. Just rolls off. Joe Loafman with the rebound, and they're going to give him a jump ball. Nope, they're going to give him a foul. That's even better. In comes Will Good and London Burton for Joey and Joe. Joe's walking off the court together. Wyatt Lewis with the three. Oh, just doesn't get it. Stags with the rebound. Zay with the more zone coverage there. London also in zone. Looks like they're not. They're man-to-man zone kind of thing. I think London might start pressuring a little more. Stags passing it around. They're looking for an inside pass. Can't seem to find it, though. They push on the inside. They jump up for it. They can't get it. Will Good with the rebound. They're going to give him a foul. Stags fouled Mr. Good. Zay passing it into Will. Stags still doing their full court press here. Good with the ball. Passing it underneath to Lewis. Lewis tries to take it inside. Pass it out to Welsh. Welsh just goes a little too far. London with the rebound, though. Zay thinking about it. Doesn't do it. Wyatt thinking about the long shot. Takes it to the inside. Loses the ball a little bit. Stags rebound. And it's going to go out of bounds. Stags trying to save it, but his foot was on the line. So that's going to be Saints ball. 5:50 left. 16-12. Saints have yet to score a bucket in this second quarter. They're taking a 30-second timeout. So I have a feeling Cooper Smith here is probably going to suggest that the boys start taking easier shots, try to get into the inside for the layup rather than just taking the three. Three is not a bad idea considering the fact that they've made so many today. London with two from the corner and Lewis from one just at the top of the key. So I would suggest they start trying to go for some layups just to keep the lead. Their defense is doing pretty good. Stag's just getting a couple lucky shots off. So let's see what they come out with here. Let's see if that's the game plan. Maybe get some inside to Will Good. Tall man on the inside. Just put it up. Here we go. Welsh pass it to Zay. Zay takes a light jumper for two. Almost like I just suggested that. Stags with the ball. London going to meet him at the top of the key. Zay tries to block the pass. Will Good on the inside, putting up his hands like an absolute skyscraper. There's not a chance they make that shot. Zay with the Euro step, and he gets the bucket. London with the defense. Stags looking to set something up here. No one has yet to enter the lane for the Stags. They're only looking around the outside. Taking it back up to the top, trying to reset. Looks like the Saints have foiled their plans. Stag still looking. Tried to take it inside, end up popping the three off the back of the rim. Stags get the rebound, and they just keep pushing in. Will Good with the tip. Tries to recover it before it goes out of bounds, and it's just out. Stags got the ball. Let's see if they can do something to stop the Saints defense. However, I don't think that's possible. London waiting for Stags to start making a move. Passing it around the outside. Looking for a middleman, looks like. They're calling a foul on possibly Cooper Welsh for a personal foul. Might have just been tugging on the jersey a little bit. It's a physical game, this game. Stags pass it in. Wyatt Lewis with the clamp down on defense. Ends up putting enough pressure for the Stags to miss their shot there. And they get the rebound. Wyatt Lewis going all by himself, puts it up to the top, just doesn't get it. Will Good with the rebound, pass it to Cooper Welsh. Welsh to London. London for three. He's hot on the right side of the key tonight. Put him on the left and see what happens. I think it's the same result. Stags with the ball. Down by 11. London does not fall for the pick. And the Stags call a full timeout, it looks like. So here's another video from our team.
Say your name again, go.
I'm Layla.
I'm Tatum.
What year are you?
I'm a freshman. And I'm a senior.
What's your favorite color?
Pink. I like purple.
What's your favorite food?
Steak.
Chicken.
If there was one animal you could do without, what would it be?
A snake.
Anteater.
Name something that rhymes with dime.
Time. Lime.
Who do you guys crack on the most? Joke on.
Jemiah.
Yeah, Jemiah.
If you could switch with one person on your team, who would it be?
Coach Hetzel.
Coach Harbert.
Popeyes or Cane's?
Cane's.
If you could give one piece of advice, what would it be?
Live in the moment.
Probably jump stop, or you, and then you won't get yelled at.
Thanks for listening.
All right, welcome back from that amazing video, getting to know a little bit about our girls basketball team, who, as I mentioned earlier, beat the girls Miege team. 57-56, an absolute thriller at the end. Came back down by at least 14, I think, and came out with the victory. So now we're back to the boys' game, 23-12, 3:32 left in the second quarter and the half. Stags trying to push on the inside, just bodying their way through, but they can't get that off. Zay with the jump up for the rebound. Tries to pass it to the inside to Will Good, and it gets broken up by the Stags. Stags pushing back down the court for a fast break, but they're not going to be able to get off a shot here since the Saints got back so quickly. That was a walk, but what do I know? I guess you get two steps, but I thought that was going for the bucket. Whatever. Tries to put up the shot, and they get the three. And the Stags student section over there turned up for this game. However, Will Good draws the and one after getting the pass from Zay Freeman. The voices from the other side do not penetrate the mind of the Saints. Will Good going to the line, shooting two. Stags make a substitute. Will Good with his first. Despite the stray cat in the building, he makes that bucket for the three-point play. Take the three. They do not get it. Zay with the rebound. That vertical was insane. Looking for a pass. Pass it to London. London's thinking about going inside, but he is good as covered in the middle. They're going to call a foul on the Stags. Looks like a hold on Will. It's going to be an inbounds play. It's on the ground. Here goes the Saints. Inbounds play. Looking for somebody. Pass it to White Lewis, who pops the three. Oh, just off the back. It's close. Stags taking it down. They're not waiting for anybody. Oh. Wyatt Lewis just wanted to make the statement known that he was there to block that shot. However, they're giving it to Zay for the push. So it's going to be shooting two. And London Burton way in the backcourt right now. Just waiting for the Saints to get back. I have a feeling they're going to give a large pass because they're going to full court press this. They didn't. He got covered. Zay gets it across the line. Inside to Cooper Welsh, who puts up the layup. Easy shot there for 28. Cooper Welsh with the interception. Keeps his feet in bounds. Looking like a football player out there. Oh, that's going to be a foul. Stag's parents not happy about that one, but I think that was perfectly a great call. Here goes Cooper Welsh for the one. This is it. Cooper Welsh at the second. makes it, despite the very enthusiastic crowd of the other team's student section. Stags passing it around the top, looking for anything, really. But I think the Saints' defense is too much for them to bear. Tipped out of bounds by the Saints. It's going to be Stags' ball. 29-17, 12-point lead here for the Saints. A minute 27 left. Stags passing it around a little bit. Looking for it. Saints playing a little zone. Off. Bad pass by the Stags. It's off the foot of Good. And it's going to be a jump ball going the way of Miege. We got all the sports out there. We got football, basketball, and soccer. Ball's hitting off the foot like that. Wasn't a kick, but. They're going to give a foul to Welsh there for something I really don't know. And Stags missed that one. Shooting their second. Joe Loafman going in for Cooper Welsh. I got Wyatt Lewis, London Burton, Zay Freeman, Will Good, and Joe Loafman. Mr. Fox just bringing us some halftime snacks. Love to see it. Joe Loafman on the inside, looking for the shot, gets it on the outside, tries to put up the hook, gets the rebound of his own shot. Wyatt Lewis now has the ball. Trying to get something going here in the final 38 seconds. See what he can do. Pass it to London. London's thinking about it. Pass it to Good. Good, waiting. Picks up his dribble, pass it to Wyatt. Wyatt has the ball in between the legs, tries to push in. Passes it to London. Zay trying to crash the boards. They got 13 seconds. Wyatt Lewis, they're running out of time. Pushes it to the inside, pass it to Joe Loafman. And they're going to get him on a thing. Stags 3-2-1, puts up the layup and he gets it. Final score, Saints up by 10 at half, 29-19. See you in the second. Hello there, and welcome back to the second half of this boys varsity game versus Bishop Miege. It is 29-19. The boys have a 10-point lead coming out of a first quarter that was very much dominated by the Saints, only not having the lead once. One lead change. And it's been like this ever since. Saints now get the ball for the second half. Passing it around, looking for something to do here. They down the baseline, tries to pass it down to Cooper Welsh. Gets bobbled out of his hands, and he falls down. Stags with the ball. Going up for the layup. They don't get it, but they do get the rebound. Passing it back up to the top to try and reset the play. Saints looking more man coverage. Nope, it's zone. I lied to you. Had to watch it for a second. Stags get the rebound off of that three. Saints trying to get a stop here. Stags pass underneath, trying to just push their way to the center. Will Good tips it out of the hands of the Stags player. However, it goes out of bounds off of him. Stags resetting their play. Passing it around. Thinking about a three or a pass to the inside. Usually that's the idea. Number 10 goes up for the shot. Does not get it. Will Good with the rebound. Pass it underneath to Welsh. Welsh taking it down. Looks to Wyatt Lewis. Wyatt Lewis passes to the outside to Zay in the corner. Oh, just rims out. Will Good almost with the rebound. Tips back. They're going to call a foul here. Probably on Will Good for that attempted tip back to the Saints. It was almost successful. Just a little bit too physical. 29-19. 6:12 left. Stags. The top of their key. Take it down the inside of the lane. Put up a layup. And they get it. Cooper Welsh passing it to Zay. Zay to Welsh. Welsh to Lewis. Lewis to Welsh. They're just going back and forth, looking for a way to do it. Good on the inside. Back to London. London pulls the three, and he gets it. Like I said, he's hot tonight on that three-point line. Pretty sure he is 3-for-3. Welsh with the defense there. Lewis putting a hand in the face, trying to get a little disruption. Number 10 with the fancy feet. Passing it around. 12 goes the inside. Puts up the layup. Zay taking it back down for the Saints. Welsh to the inside to Will Good, who puts it up. Does not get the layup. Another jump, and they're going to get the foul. Here's a little timeout. 32-23. 4 minutes left. Actually, it's almost five, but, you know, it's besides the point. I don't know what Cooper Smith is going to be cooking up here, because, honestly, that defense has been pretty good. Pretty locked in. Pretty locked down. They've been taking the easy shots. They haven't really been pulling the three unnecessarily, which is good. And I have a feeling that we're going to mostly stick with the same strategy, just a little pep talk. Just a little pep talk. I think that's what's going on now. Get a little bit of a pep in the step before Will Good takes these free throws. Well, good. At the line. Despite the screams, he gets that one. 33-23. Stags ball. Looking to pass it around here. Maybe for the three. Thinks about it. Doesn't take it. Pushes into the inside. Will, with the defense, thinks about a three. Goes back to the inside. Doesn't quite get it, but he gets the rebound. And they're going to call a foul on the Saints. Student section has grown a little bit. Some of the girls from the girls varsity team have showed up. Show support for the seniors tonight. Here goes Miege for their second. And there we go. 25-33. 4 minutes, 20 seconds left on the clock. Good, getting it across the line. They pass it to the inside to London, who gets trapped over there. Pass it to Will, who gets the play off the baseboard. Baseline, sorry. And a lot of passing. Ends with a foul on Will Good. That was a great awareness play, knowing where his teammate was. Zay Freeman ends up getting a chance for the free throw. Will Good makes both of those, despite the attempts of the Miege student section, who had to get a talking to by their teacher. Stags passing it around. Looking for a pass. Doesn't see one yet. Goes back to the top. London Burton breaks up the... Oh. Breaks up the pass. Just does not quite get a hold of the ball. I'm sure he probably would have gone down there and dunked that thing. Would have loved to see that. It's all right. 10-point lead here for the Saints. 3 minutes, 40 seconds left. Stags ball. What? That's going to be a foul on the Stags. There you go. Little Stags foul there. Saints get the ball. Zay with the ball. Passes it across the line to Will Good, who receives it. Gets broken up a little bit. Recovered by Cooper Welsh, who is now trying to find a pass. Gives it to Zay Freeman. Zay Freeman takes it to the inside. Back up to Will. Will gets quad covered in the middle. Doesn't matter, though. Puts it up for the two. That height really gives him the advantage there. Zay tries to get the coverage, but the Stags get the ball to go in. Trying to get the ball across the line here with a double coverage. White loose, takes to the inside, tries to get the layup going, can't quite get it. 4-on-4 right now down there. London gets the rebound. Back to Zay. Zay passes it down the court to Welsh. Welsh to the outside to Wyatt. Wyatt for the three. Absolute bucket. Never a doubt in his mind. From the corner. Threes have been dropping today. 40-27. 13-point lead here. Stags ball. Passing it around. Minute 50 left. Wyatt. Defense. Stags hit the ball to fall. Zay inbounds to Welsh. Stags elect to not press this time. Good on the inside. Pass it to the outside to Lewis. Lewis with the fader. Can't quite get it to fall. Stags with the quick breakaway. And Cooper Welsh tries his best to defend that. However, they get the easy layup. 9 points separate the two teams. Zay trying to get a play going. London with the ball. Pass it to Welsh. Welsh to Good. Good thinking about Lewis. Fakes him out for the inside for the layup. It was a very similar looking thing to the thing they did before, as the Saints draw a foul there on Miege. I want to go back to that last play there where it was a similar play. Cooper Welsh had the ball. Pass it to the inside to Will Good. On the last one, Will Good passed it to the outside to Lewis, who then took the inside. So this time, Will Good looks to the outside, fakes out the defense, and gets them all to jump off so then he can just take it straight to the bucket one-on-one. What a brilliant play. Many substitutes just happened. The only remaining players is Cooper Welsh, Joey Goodnow, Colin Smith, Joe Loafman, and Brett Yankovic coming in for everyone else. And that is a huge foul there. Cooper Welsh keeping the ball. Takes it to Colin. Colin to Goodnow. Goodnow's looking for a pass. Goes all the way across. Loafman with the ball to the inside. Oh, gets broken up by the Stags. Colin Smith running. Can't quite get there in time, but he caught up. Stags with the layup. Saints ball. Cooper Welsh with the ball, looking for a pass. Looks to the inside to Joe Loafman. Back to the outside to Welsh. Welsh to Loafman. Loafman getting tipped around. Welsh to Smith. Smith across to Welsh. Takes it to the inside for the layup. Way to take it to the inside before the end of the quarter there. I didn't even notice the clock was running down. 44-35. 9-point lead here for the Saints going into the fourth quarter. So far, it's been a great game. Mostly dominated by the Saints. Only time the Stags have led this game was the first quarter, where it was 4-3, and then it was 8-6. After that, the Saints came back to take an 8-point lead, 16-8. And ever since then, it's just kept going up. Saints cheer team getting the student section extremely hyped up. Look at them. Enthralled in this epic showdown. As I said earlier, it grew a little bit. We got some of the girls varsity basketball players out there. 8 minutes left. One more quarter. Can the Saints bring it home? Out there for the Saints is the same lineup we had going into the fourth from the third. Stags get the ball. They are passing it around, trying to get a play going. Colin Smith with the coverage. Joey Goodnow trying to break free, ends up tipping that, takes it down, tries to put up the layup, and gets tripped. They're going to give him a shooting foul here so he can take two. Joey's a very physical player. Take some of those football traits that he has. Gets the job done no matter what. Joey with a second. Joey doesn't quite get that one to fall. Stags hit the rebound. Take it back down court. Okay. They're going to make that a block on Cooper Welsh there. He was jumping, but they're going to call it a shooting foul, which I wasn't really paying attention to. And they're first, and they make it. 36-44, 8-point game. For those of you who don't know, the way bonus works in high school now this year is once a team gets 5 team fouls for the quarter, it goes into bonus. So far, each team is only at 1 foul, though. After each quarter, though, it will reset, so that's why we're only at 1 foul. Zay getting it across the line to Cooper Welsh. Welsh with the fake takes it to the rim himself. Miege with the ball. Looking for the pass. Number 2. Takes it up the lane himself. Passes it at the last second to 16. And they get the layup. Saints with the ball. Zay getting it to Colin. Colin back to Zay. Zay up to the top to Welsh. They are passing it around. Looking for a way to get this defense off of them. Loafman takes it by himself. Tries to pass it around the outside of the defender to get it to Joey. Can't quite get it off. And the Stags get a 2. To make this a 5-point game. Cooper Welsh slowing it down for the Saints. Colin with the ball. Gives it to Joey. Joey thinks about a pass. Goes back across to Welsh. Welsh to Smith. Smith thinks about the 3. Takes it to the inside himself. Puts it up. Can't quite get it. And Stags get the rebound. However, Joey going for the jump. And he will get that. And back in for the Saints, we got Wyatt Lewis, Joe Lopin came off the court. Cooper Welsh, Will Good, Wyatt Lewis, Zay Freeman, and Lennon Burton. Your starting 5 back out there. Wyatt Lewis takes the 3, can't quite get it off. Defense here. And Miege tips it out at the last second. I'm not quite sure who it was off originally, but it's going to be Saints ball. And Cooper Welsh taking it up the court. 5 minutes, 50 seconds left on the clock. Cooper Welsh passing it to Wyatt Lewis. Wyatt Lewis passing it back. London thinks about the 3. He's been hot from that spot tonight. Wyatt Lewis looking for the pass. Cooper Welsh. They're thinking about Will Good there, but he is covered. So they try to get it to Zay. Welsh takes it by himself to the inside. Can't quite get it. However, oh. Miege gets the rebound there. Welsh breaks up the dribble, and it goes out of bounds off his tip. So that's going to be Miege ball. They're going to give it to the Saints. Calling it a moving screen, I think. Not quite sure what it was, to be honest, but they're calling it full timeout here. And have a look at our student section or the band. Both of them, why not? Cheerleaders back at it again. Ian Orrick right there. Charlie Ford getting moved up with Max Coran and Maverick Farrar. Your 2023 state championship cheerleaders. They went back to back, 2022 and 2023. Can they do 2024 this year? We'll have to wait and see. There's the band. Looks like a little drum solo there for the senior, Brendan Fallis. Hit everything, why not? Good job, Brendan. Good job. Back to the game. It's going to be Saints ball here. Zay Freeman passing it in to Cooper Welsh. The coach of the Miege is putting in his word with the ref there. I'm not quite sure what that's about, but making his statement clear. Saints with the ball, passing it around. Looks like Wyatt Lewis is wide open. He's thinking about the three, but he makes a smart choice and gives it to Zay. London on the outside. Cooper Welsh, Wyatt back with the ball. Thinking about it, doesn't want to take it. Gives it to Zay, who does, and he gets it. Drippy water bucket splash. And that's going to be a foul on the Saints, so they will be shooting two. Each team now has two team fouls. That's going to be going on London. Miege misses their first. See if the student section will make any noise in the absolutely quiet gym. It's very easy. And Miege makes their second. So it's going to be Saints ball. Looks like Miege is going to do a full press here. Try and get the ball. Will Good with it right now. Looking for the pass. Decides to take it. Pass it to Zay, who passes it to London, who gets it across. Zay covered pretty well. Pass it to Lewis. And Lewis gives it to Welsh. Welsh to Zay. And they're going to... Zay was trying to give the pass to Good there, but it seemed to be a foul on Miege. That pass was intercepted, so this is a turnover here for Saints. Gotta get the ball. Cooper Welsh, inbounds play. Looking for the pass. And he finds Zay at the top of the key. Zay thinks about the three and he takes it. Oh! From downtown, country roads, take me home. Saints with the defense. London gets the ball. Dribbles it around a little bit to pass it to Wyatt Lewis. Lewis to Freeman. Freeman to Good. Good puts it up for the two and gets the and one. Back to the line for Will Good tonight. And looks like this full timeout from Miege, I think. Yes, full timeout by Miege. Another look at the student section. Why not? Miles McDaniel right there, and that's Diego. Cooper Smith, giving the ideas here. What's he cooking up in there? Hopefully some tasty, tasty food for the boys to eat. And Will Good back to the line here. See if he can make these. And Will makes it for the three-point play. That's the second and one conversion tonight. Stags with the ball. Down by 13 points. London. They take the three. They do not get it. However, almost rebounded by the Stags, but it is tipped out of bounds. 3 minutes, 3 seconds left on the clock in the fourth quarter and the game. Zay passing it to Good. Good looking for the pass. Getting covered. And they're going to give him, they're going to take a timeout here. Saints are. Just to save their team from the backcourt clock violation. So far, quite an enjoyable game. 55-42. 2 minutes, 56 seconds left. Here we go. Inbounds play to hopefully get him across the half-court line. They give it to London Burton, who will just dribble it across himself, being covered. Pass it up top to Cooper Welsh, who tries to take it inbounds, but ends up getting stopped there. Welsh tries again. Oh, that's close. Try to get the two-step pass to Will, but it gets broken up. And we're going to give a foul to London Burton for push. The Stags are only one team foul away from pushing the Saints into bonus. And the Saints have three team fouls currently. Stags just trying to body their way in there, but they can't get that off. Will good with the rebound. Gives it to Welsh, who pushes it up. Thinks about the three, does not take it, and ends up getting fouled on 12. And that will push the Saints into bonus. So bonus free throws here for Welsh. Going to the line. Welsh with his first, and he gets it. His second. And he makes it. 57-42. Stags with the ball. 2 minutes and 2 seconds left. And Wyatt Lewis gets the ball from the Stags. Gives it to Lennon Burton, who puts up the layup for the easy two. 59-42. Stags trying to push it inside. Can't quite get it. Wyatt Lewis breaks it up again. And they're going to give him the foul this time. That was a little bit more hand than ball, but that's okay. 17-point lead here. Joe Loafman coming in for Will Good. It is senior night. Having all three seniors on the court at once. Cooper Welsh tries to break it up, but he can't quite get it. But Joe Loafman does. Tips it out of bounds. And the Stags try to get the easy layup, but it does not drop. Zay taking it down the court. Pass it to Wyatt Lewis, who takes it to the inside. Pass it back out to Zay. Zay thinks about the three. He puts up the two, and he gets it. Easy jumper. 61-42. Stags put up the three. Can't quite get it to go. And they do get that and one chance there. And out comes Wyatt Lewis. In goes Colin Smith. Stags make that three. And there goes Cooper Welsh, getting a standing ovation, same as Wyatt did. In goes Joey Goodenow, the last remaining senior being Joe Loafman. Colin Smith picks up his ball. They need to get across the half-court line. They do. Colin Smith takes him to the promised land. Zay Freeman thinking about the three. Does not quite get it. Passes to the inside to Joe Loafman. Gives it to Colin Smith. Who gives it to Jay? Zay, who takes a three? Can't quite get it off, but Joey Goodenow with the rebound. Puts up the two, and he gets the points. 37 seconds left on the clock. And out comes Joe Loafman. In goes Brett Yankovic. An all-junior team here. As the last seconds wind down, what a great season these seniors have had, and what a great 4 years they've had here at Aquinas. Stags make that one, and in comes Nick Sabers. And Baron Gavin. who are both sophomores. So now we no longer have a full junior team. Brett Yankovic with a jump stop. Joey Good now gives it to Colin Smith. Colin Smith gives it to Brett, who gives it to Sabres. Sabres to Gavin. Oh, Gavin gets it stolen. And these Stags are going to get an easy bucket there to make it 49-63. 1 second left on the clock. And Sabres are just going to hold the ball to bring the Saints to victory. I think I've realized what Coach Cooper Smith was cooking up. He was cooking up a little winner, winner, chicken dinner down there in those timeouts. Saints bring it home. They win 63-49. I've been Matthew Fortino, signing off.